Rosie, this is a really simple pasta that I like to do at home. Some tuna, pasta, a little bit of olive oil, very, very healthy. But the first thing you need to do is take the top off this packet of pasta, and I use scissors because it comes off nice and easily. I'm using bow tie pasta. Have a look at that.
Oh, that's lovely,
isn't
it? You
could dress yourself up with a little bow tie or butterfly pasta, farfalle they call it.
I do look good in a tux, I must say.
You do look good in a tux, I'm sure. And I'll pour the pasta in here. 500 grams, enough for a lot of people. And that goes. Now, we need some salt in there because we need it to taste like the Mediterranean Sea. So in goes a nice amount of salt, which is about a quarter of a cup, which is what I like to put in there. And give it a bit of a stir just to make sure that that bow tie pasta doesn't stick to anything. The thing about bow tie pasta, kids love it. And there are so many different types of pasta, different shapes. So you want to pick out something that kids love and they can play around with it.
Make anything a fun shape, and I think kids consider it a little bit more.
It's like a game, isn't it?
Yeah, it's funny.
All right, Rosie, there's no game here because we need to get on to our cooking.
Okay.
I've got anchovies here and I've got capers. I want you to pull out a couple of anchovies into that bowl, pull out a couple of capers and throw that in there as well.
You got it.
I'm going to smash these garlic cloves, chop them up nice and rough because I want them to be nice and chunky. And speaking of chunky, I've got some onion here and I'll cut the core off them and I'll slice these nice and chunky as well.
Lovely.
All the way through. And as you cut it, you sort of go around the top of it like that. And then we get these lovely chunks of onion. And then some extra virgin olive oil into my pan. A good old splush, which is good oil apparently, isn't it?
Splush, this word, I'm not even sure what it means, but I just go with it. But,
a splush-a-roni. Turn that up a little bit and we want to get our...
It's got even worse.
Exactly. Onion and garlic sweating away. That's what we like. Some chilli goes in there as well.
Yep.
And you can slice it down through the middle here and remove all the seeds, but I want the seeds in there. I want it to be nice and hot and this will be my favourite type of pasta. Of course, if you're serving this up for kids, probably don't put any chilli in it.
Because maybe not.
Most little kids don't like chilli. So anchovies go in there. Hairy fish, I like to call it. I love cooking with anchovy because it gives it a great flavour.
Great flavour and also lots and lots of good fats.
Exactly.
Which is what it's all about. Really, really good.
Now, I've got some tuna here, Rosie. There's your fork and I've got mine. The tuna, I've taken the lid off and it's got a little chilli in there. This is light tuna.
Yep.
And I make sure I keep the juice as well because the juice will be part of the dish and make it really flavoursome. I like to put it out on a plate like this and break it up just a little bit so it comes apart.
This is a great weekday evening dish, isn't it? Because it's so fast.
It comes together in minutes. I usually finish work quite late, so when I come home and I'm hungry, I don't want to wait too long. I want to get it into my belly as fast as I can. Stir that around like that. Now, Rosie, over there, I've got some herbs, so some dill and some parsley. Just chop it nice and rough so we can get it right in.
You got
it. Just rip into it. A little bit of stem is okay. Now, some capers will go in here, about a tablespoon of capers. We'll put the whole lot of it in there. I love capers. They give it a really sort of acidic, savoury, sort of salty flavour. And at this stage here, I'll put that tuna in here. Now, I like a bit of liquid in this as well. I don't want to have it too hot. So a little ladle of the pasta water in here will help to give it a bit of body. Now, about a minute or so of stirring and I reckon my pasta should be ready to go. And I reckon by then you'll have that parsley and the dill chopped, the board cleaned down, and we'll be ready to put this together. Okay, that's looking beautiful, Rosie. And the pasta cooked to perfection. Now it's time to bring it all together. I'll use my little spider here. We call this a spider.
Yeah.
Because it looks like a spider's web, I believe.
It's actually such a good tool to have in the kitchen.
Makes everything nice and convenient to pull out of a pot of water. Look at that. Woo-hoo. Looks fantastic. And you can have a little bit of the water from the pasta go in there as well.
Yeah.
Helps to lubricate it. Some salt goes on there, some pepper goes on there. Rosie, herbs, load me up. Load me
you
up with those herbs.
We've
plenty
it.
Of it on there. And I'll load your hands up with some pepper as well.
Great.
Fantastic. Plenty of pepper on there. Now, just need a little bit of a toss around like that to make sure everything's nicely combined. And then I'll just grab this spider here over to this plate here. And then it's a matter of loading up this beautiful plate here till it's all ready to go to eat. Look at that.
Well, that will feed. I mean, that could potentially feed four. Have a little side salad there as well.
Exactly.
Or, you know, two big rugby players.
Two big rugby plates, or maybe just one. Spoon some of that Parmesan cheese over the top. Some people like cheese with their fish, some people don't, doesn't matter. Whatever
That's
you
true.
Like is up to you. And then, of course, some of the tuna there, some of the pasta, some caper in there as well.
Well, it looks delicious.
Mm.
That's one to add to your belt just for during the week, isn't it?
It is fantastic. Mm. Really spicy as well. I love the tuna flavour through there. plenty of good fats, plenty of tastiness and plenty of healthiness. This is a cracker of a dish, Rosie.
I feel smarter already.